So the cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling, each one holding one of my mother's hands, and she the big girl. Some 12 years or so, all three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera. A sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born. And the sea, which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet. Some 20, 30 years later, she would laugh at the snapshot. "See, Betty and Dolly," she would say, "and look how they dressed us for the beach." The sea holiday was her past. Mine is her laughter. Both writhe with the labored ease of loss. Now she's been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived. And of this circumstance, there is nothing to say at all. Its silence silences. So children, we were talking about photograph, like what does a photograph symbolize? So photograph is symbolic of what? Can you give me the answers? What is photograph symbolic of? You can raise hand to answer. What is photograph symbolic of? Okay, photograph is symbolic of memories. Okay, photograph is all about the memories which we store for the future reference. Okay, in future, if we need to have a look at our past, then photographs are the best way to do that. So photographs are symbolic of memory lanes. Then what's the best way to preserve a photograph? How can we keep a photograph safe? For this answer, you have to forget that nowadays we have got so many other, we have got the technology to save our photographs. Forget that. In earlier times, when the technology was not there, when the Google and all had not come, then what was a way to save the photographs? Our parents or grandparents, they used to keep the photograph in a wooden framework. So that wooden framework, or you can say the frame in which the photograph was kept or pasted, that was a way to preserve or save a photograph for years to come, right? So here is that cardboard. The cardboard shows me how it was. So how can you go through the memory lanes? How can you recollect your past? Number one, through the photographs, and the photographs which are kept in the cardboard. And the poet also was able to see his past. He was able to remember his past. He was able to make out like how it was when even he was not born. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling. So that cardboard is a proof of the time, is a witness of the time, how poet's mother spent her childhood, how poet's mother had her sea holiday replete with fun at the sea beach. At the time, even the poet was not born. Okay, so the cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling. Who are the two? When the two girl cousins went paddling, each one holding one of my mother's hands. So two girl cousins went for paddling with the poet's mother. Okay. So this incident is reflected through the photograph, which is pasted on a cardboard. So cardboard is a witness to the day when poet's mother went for a sea holiday with her two girl cousins. And those two girl cousins were holding mother's hand from either side. Why were they holding mother's hands from either side? Because mother was a big girl. So poet's mother was the eldest of all the cousins. So she was in the center and the other two cousins were on her either side. So they went into the sea beach. They went to the sea beach to enjoy a sea holiday. So at that time, some 12 years or so, who was 12 years at that time? Mother, poet's mother at the time was 12 years of age. So the time when poet was not born, that was not, that was like out of question, because poet's mother herself was only 12 years at that time. So she was 12, and her girl and her other cousins might have been even younger to her. So they were lesser than 12. So they were holding her hands from both sides, and all three stood still to smile through their hair. And when they went to the sea beach, there they stood at the sea beach and gave a beautiful pose to be photographed. All three are the girl cousins and the mother. So two cousins and mother, they all posed smilingly to be photographed. Okay, stood still. They stood still means they stood motionless so that they could be photographed. And at the time when they were posing for the photograph, they were smiling. Number one, they were standing still. Number two, they were smiling. And number three, they were smiling through their hair means that at the time the wind was blowing. It was a sea beach. And at the sea beach, you cannot expect the stillness to prevail. So at the sea beach, the nature was at its best. So at the sea beach, the air, the wind was blowing. And that blowing wind made these girls, you know, their hair fly like anything. So their hair might have covered a part of their face. Their hair might have also covered their smile. So they were smiling at a time when the wind was blowing and their hair were all, flying about. And they even covered a part of their face. At the uncle with the camera. So what is at the uncle? They posed for the uncle because he was the photographer with the camera. So uncle was the one who was having camera and he was taking photograph. A sweet face, my mother's. That was before I was born. So the photograph shows, the photograph is a witness that my mother at the time was very beautiful. She had a sweet and innocent face. And it was a time when even I was not born. And the sea, which appears to have changed to less, washed their terribly transient feet. So the time when the photograph was clicked, at the time the mother was very sweet and innocent. And the photograph is also a witness to the time when the sea, where the sea waves were also visibly washing the feet of mother or the cousins. So photograph shows number one, the mother, number two, the other two girl cousins, number three, the sea, the photograph also shows the sea waves. What kind of sea waves? At the time, the sea waves were touching the feet of the girls, three girls. And the photograph is a witness that during these years, the mother who was at that time 12 years, now when the poet is looking at the photograph, she is not there. She has died. But the sea waves, they have not changed over these years. The sea waves are there as it is. So the photograph, it shows two things. Number one, mother who was at that time 12 years old, but now that mother is no more. Second thing, the sea waves which seemed to be washing the feet of the girls, that sea seems to have changed less. Why it has changed less? Because the sea is still there. If the poet goes to the sea, he will be or she will be again able to see the sea as it is there. So what's the idea? What's the underlying idea of these lines, of this stanza? That man is mortal, whereas nature is immortal. Man may come or man may go, but nature remains there. Okay, but the nature the you know the nature, its life goes on and on like that. Apart from this, there is one more thing which has withstood the ravages of time. Can you tell what is the third thing? I'm telling you that there are two things about which the poet is talking about. Man is mortal, nature is immortal. There is something else about which the poet is referring to as something which is still there. What is that? Raise hand and give me the answer. What is the other thing which is still there? Yes? Yes, Samriddhi?
Memories.
Yes, beta?
Memories of the
repeat,
poet.
Let me make it louder. Yeah, now you repeat.
Memories of the poet with his mother.
Memories. Okay, but at the time the memories were not there. When the mother went to enjoy the sea holiday, at that time the poet was not there. The poet is talking about something which was there at that time. Riddhi, yes? Unmute yourself.
Yes? Transient.
Transient feet. This I'll explain, wait. But this is not the answer. There is something very clearly written that something is there, which is still there.
See,
I have already told you that sea is there. Sea is there. Mother is not there. Cousins are there or not, we don't know. But one thing is clear, that that man is mortal. Yes, Diya.
Her smile and sweet face.
Repeat, Diya, please.
From her smile through their hair.
No, beta, even smile means who was smiling in the photograph? Mother and her cousins. But mother is no more. If mother is not there, then how can her smile be there?
Okay.
Apply your mind. Tell me, what's the third thing which is there in the, which is still there? Okay, Samriddhi? Yes? Anyone else? Come on, raise hand. Roll number 26, Aditi. Give the answer. 11th B, Aditi.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Is there something else which is still there?
My photograph.
Yes, correct answer. Photograph. The photograph is still there. This photograph was clicked on the same day when the mother and girl cousins were there at the sea holiday. So this photograph's age is also almost the same as is the age. But photograph's age is no doubt 12 years lesser than the mother's age, but it belongs to the same era. Okay, so the photograph is there. So photograph which was clicked to preserve the memories, that photograph is also there. The cardboard is still there. The cardboard which was kept to preserve the photograph, that is also there. So the photograph or the cardboard, they are also there. So the point is, only man doesn't remain there for a long time, whereas the things, they are there, nature there, it's only the man who leaves us very early. Okay, so man is mortal. Things are also durable. So we people many a times value material things more than our relations. But we must spend or invest more on relations, less on materialistic things, because materialistic things will still be there and they will be of no use later on. So what the relationships or what the relations can do, the materialistic things cannot. Right? So now let us talk about the expression terribly transient feet. So when I say, If I say terribly transient feet, the first poetic device, which is very easy one, it is a ter sound is repeated, so it is alliteration. So when the two consonant sounds, when the consonant sounds are repeated, maybe consecutively or maybe in a sentence, then we call it alliteration. So this is alliteration. And another poetic device which is very prominently used here is transient feet. What's the poetic device in transient feet? Transient means something which is temporary, something which is short-lived. So can is it the feet which are temporary, or is it the is it something else which is temporary? Mind it, temporary here it is the adjective. Transient is adjective, and it is used for feet. But do you think temporary adjective has been used for feet or somebody else? So here the this transient word has been used for actually human beings. Man is mortal. Mind it, the idea is that man is mortal. Man is mortal means man has to die one day. Lifespan of man is limited. Okay, so when the poet says that transient feet, transient means short-lived feet, it's not the feet actually, it is the man. Okay, not the feet. So when the adjective refers to a noun, and it should not refer to this noun, it should refer to somebody else. So it should be actually man. So when the adjective refers to a noun other than the one which is referred here, we call it transferred epithet. So the poetic device which is used over here is very important, you people need to know. Transferred epithet. So transferred epithet is a poetic device in which an adjective is used to describe a noun other than the one which is mentioned here. Actually here transient refers to man's life, but here it is referring to feet. Got it? There is one more poetic device in the same expression. If we say terribly transient feet, here feet refers to not just feet. Feet is just one part of the body. Okay, whereas feet refers to human being. So when part refers to the whole, or the whole refers to the part, we call it synecdoche. Okay, another poetic device in the same line, in the same word, is synecdoche. Got it? So here this expression terribly transient feet is very important, because here in one expression there are three poetic devices. One is ter sound has been repeated, so it is alliteration. Another word, another poetic device is when we say transient feet, here transient actually refers to the man. Okay, whose life is temporary? Man's life is temporary, not feet's life. So it is a transferred epithet. And then in the word feet itself, you know, where the feet refer to the whole human being, because whole human being's life is short, not just of the foot or of the feet. So then there the poetic device used is synecdoche. So here the poet has very smartly used three poetic devices in three words. Okay, so otherwise also in the full stanza there were so many other poetic devices, but this one is a master expression where three poetic devices have been used in just one go. Okay, and even in the beginning when the poet says the cardboard shows me what? Can cardboard show you something? So here also it is personification, where the cardboard has been given the attribute of a human being, as if it were showing something. Okay? Okay, next one is Yes, even in the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th line, all three stood still to smile. So here, sir sound is very prominent, and that is alliteration. Stood still, smile. So sir sound is very prominently used. So that is alliteration. Okay, now next, come to the next two stanzas. So in the first stanza, children, the mother, poet's mother, is 12 years of age. Okay, in the second stanza, let's see how old she is. Some 20, 30 years later, she would laugh at the snapshot. So in the first stanza, she was 12 years. And after 20 or 30 years, when she would be about, so 12 plus 30, supposing, then 42. So when she was about 32 or 42 of years, then when she would look at the photograph, she would laugh. But why will she laugh? She would laugh. She would say, see Betty and Dolly, she would say, and look how they dressed us for the beach. So why would she laugh after 20 or 30 years? She would laugh funnily. She would laugh at the way they were dressed up for the beach. Okay? So when you are small kids, you don't mind how you are dressed up. At that time, you just enjoy in whatever the way you are dressed up. But when you grow up, when you become mature, then you have fun out of the way you were dressed up funnily in your childhood. So the mother is also again having fun out of the way. She's having fun when she looks at the photograph and says that they were dressed up very funnily over there. So Betty and Dolly are the names of those girl cousins who were there with her. And look how they dressed us for the beach. The sea holiday was her past. Mine is her laughter. So the sea holiday is the past of mother. Okay. Mother was 12 years of age when she went to the sea holiday. And now she has become about 32 or 42. So sea holiday is her past. Mine is her laughter. So when the mother is looking at the photograph and is laughing the way they were dressed up for the beach, that laughter is the past of the mother, past for the poet. Because now the poet, now that mother is no more. The poet saw her mother laughing at the photograph. So that laughter has become past for the poet. Both arrive with the labeled ease of loss. So both of these memories, okay, both of these memories, they have become distorted with a sense of loss attached with them. Right? So here the poet says, the sea holiday was her past and mine is her laughter. So this is the irony of life, that the time doesn't stay for a longer time at one place. When we are enjoying for some time, that time also lapses, or that time is also over very soon. And later on, we miss that very time. So the very beautiful time which we are having right now, that is the time of some worth. And tomorrow we'll be missing this very time. And this is what the poet is actually conveying through this very expression. So both of these, you know, memories, they have become distorted with the passage of time, with a labored ease of loss. So what is labored ease of loss? So labored is something with which you struggle to overcome. Ease means something which is easy. Loss of, in case of mother, the loss is the loss of happy time, beauty or youth. And in case of the poet, the loss is the loss of mother's laughter. Right? So, and in both of the cases, maybe the, in mother's case, where the sea holiday was a time where she had so much of happiness, or when she was so beautiful, that life, that event, and for the poet, the event when the mother used to laugh while looking at the photograph. So both of these events, they have become distorted distorted because they want to, they don't want to lose it, but somewhere or the other they are not able to keep hold onto those events because the time runs like anything, because the time has wings. So now she's dead nearly as many years as that girl lived. So now she's been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived. So now she has been dead for the last 12 years. Which girl is he talking about here? As that girl lived, the girl about whom he was talking in the first stanza. So the girl who was 12 years old. So now the mother has been dead for the last 12 years. And of this circumstance, there is nothing to say at all. And of this tragic event, of this event of the death of mother, there is nothing to say because death is a big tragedy and this tragic event has silenced the poet. Its silence silences. The silence of the tragic event of death has made the poet become silent. So its silence silences. So the poetic device, repetition is there, or you can say alliteration is there, personification is there. Whose silence? The silence of event. Which event? Death. So can the death silence somebody? But the expression is that the death of a mother has made the poet become quiet. She has nothing to say now. Her heart is overwhelmed with sorrow or grief. And that grief doesn't let her speak anything. Okay? So in the end, what has made her sad? Photograph. The photograph which was clicked to keep the memories, beautiful memories, in the end has made the poet become sad. Got it? Okay, so go through the questions in the end and we'll pick up some other poem next week. So go through these questions. We already have discussed all these questions earlier. So now the time is over. So your first revision test was conducted yesterday. I guess it might have been okay. But some children have scored a little bit of less marks. Some children have scored terribly less marks. Please pay attention. Okay?